In this video, we are going to talk about how to learn to code in your teens. I've been coding since I was 18 years old. I am a software engineer today. Thank you, thank you, thank you. So I know a little something something, so I was hoping to share this knowledge with you. So welcome to the channel and consider subscribing if you enjoy this video. So I kind of broke this video into 5 different parts. So the first part is me defining computer science, just because that's a term that you might see. So I just wanted to do a quick little definition. After that, we're gonna talk about what coding language should you learn in your teens? What's the best one? After that, I'm gonna go through the different ages. I'm talking preteen to 19. I'm gonna give my advice on different ways you can learn to code. The fourth part, I'm talking all the free programs out there, the different ways you can learn to code, some resources, just in case y'all wanna look into that some more. And then finally, I'm gonna give y'all a quick little advice. You know, learning to code was one of the best decisions I've made in my entire life. So I kinda wanna just give you advice because it can be hard. It was super hard for me. Your girl was failing out here, but you know, I just kept trying, I kept practicing, and I got better. So I'm just gonna give a quick little advice at the end. Okay, so a term that you might see is computer science. So I wanted to quickly define what that is. So I think the University of Maryland did a great job at defining what is computer science. And I definitely think you should read the whole thing. I'm just gonna read one sentence from it. And it says, computer scientists deal mostly with software and software systems. So we're talking about theory, design, development, and application. So when it comes to coding, that's the development side of things. Like you might hear about software engineers, software developers, you know, we're the ones developing the different software. And an example of software is apps. You know, Instagram, you might be watching this on YouTube, TikTok, you know, all those different apps. Those are softwares, and software engineers are the ones that are like writing the code so that people can actually use it. Now let's talk about what coding language should you learn first. Now this is such a tough question to answer, but it is a very important next step when it comes to learning to code, just because, you know, let's say you had a goal of learning a new spoken language. There's Spanish, there's Yoruba, there's French, there's sign language, you know, I know a little bit, but you know, there's so many different languages out there. And then there's so many different coding languages as well. So when it comes to picking a language to learn, you know, a lot of different people, software engineers, they have so many different opinions on this. And the reason why is, even me personally, I know so many different coders, programmers, software engineers, and they have started off with every language under the sun. So I feel like this is good and bad to someone that's trying to learn how to code. The good thing is, you know, you really can't go wrong. Like, there's no right language that you need to learn first. But you know, the bad news is that there's so many different options. It can definitely be overwhelming. But hopefully I'm gonna like spit some things at you and you can figure out what's best for you. So, you know, some people say it's good to start off with the harder languages. You know, these are considered lower level, so it's closer to zeros and ones, but you know, that's all nonsense right now. People are saying that maybe you should do the harder ones. And their reasoning be, you know, you go through the hard stuff, then when it comes to learning different languages, easier languages, you know, you kind of been through the hard stuff, so it'll be easier to learn that. And they say you might appreciate different languages more after going through the hard stuff. That is a route, that is an option. There's another group, you know, I'm kind of in that group, where they say like it's better to start with an easier language. And when I'm saying easy, languages, coding languages can be hard to learn. It was hard to learn for me. So there's no easy in this. You know how even spoken languages, like some languages are just harder to learn than others? It's kind of like that with programming languages as well. So some people are like, look, you don't want to quit this. You want to keep going. You don't want to get too overwhelmed. If you're actually trying to learn like coding type concepts, and then it's better to start with a language that makes it easier to do so. So that is one opinion out there. You know, a whole other group of people say like, if you know what you're passionate about, like you know for sure you want to do app development for like iPhones, like you just really know that, then learn a language that's specific to that. I also think that's really great advice. So, you know, that's kind of like the different opinions, the main opinions that are out there. From my own experience, I started learning Java. That was my first programming language.
And Java was also a language that I used at my first tech job. So, you know, there's that. A language that I use for like interviews. So for example, if I want a new job, I have to go through a technical interview where sometimes you have to like code on the spot. I use Python. Like Python, the way you like write things out is just easier than other languages. You know, there's JavaScript. JavaScript, I use that language at two different companies I worked at so far. I think it might be the most widely used coding language, you know, so you can't go wrong with that. So answering the question of what coding language, and I've used coding and programming, you know, interchangeably, and for the purpose of this video, that's totally fine. So when it comes to what coding language should I learn first? You know, maybe you're in school and there's a teacher that teaches a Java course, then go ahead, you know, learn Java first. At the end of the day, you can't go wrong. And if you really, really, really just don't know what to do, I would recommend Python. I have some Python tutorials on my channel. I got you. And yeah, that would be my advice. But you know, feel free to leave your advice in the comments below. Someone else might read it and it will speak to them. And really, you can't go wrong. There's no best language to learn first. Okay, so now I'm going to talk about how you can learn to code if you're between like the preteen, maybe to age like 15. So, you know, at this age, I think getting an exposure to coding would be so key and just kind of like something great that you can do. So I recommend this to everyone. Actually, it doesn't matter your age. I think what you should try is some block-based coding. And you know, block-based coding is basically a great way to get an introduction to like, what is coding? And they have different blocks that represent code, and they kind of make a fun way to get an introduction to coding. So in this video, I talk about different block-based coding programs you can do. And you don't have to spend like weeks on block-based coding. You can just find an hour. They actually have hour of code activities that focus on this. And I talk about it a lot in this video, so definitely check out that video. At this age, you can also do street code. I love street code. I volunteered there. And what they have is basically programs of all ages where you can learn how to create video games. You can learn how to code in specific languages. Like they have Python classes. And you know, it's just a great resource that you can use. They even have online classes. So that's what I would do, you know, if I was at that age. And then also, Gen Z, this is your time to shine. I know y'all know how to Google. Y'all be Googling cheat codes for your games. Y'all be Googling your fave TV show actors. Like, I know y'all know how to Google. So feel free to Google free programs to learn to code near me. Learn to code in Kansas City. Where can I learn to code if I'm 13? You know, like, go crazy with the Googling. Also, feel free to reach out to teachers, reach out to your parents, classmates, reach out to different people and ask them like, hey, I'm interested in coding. How should I get started? Where should I get started? Feel free to ask maybe, you know, your computer teacher if you have to take typing class. I had to take typing class. Not sure that's still a thing. I'm dying, but you get the gist. Okay, I'm better now, you know, I was choking on all this great information. But anyway, now if you're between the ages of 16 to 19, still you can do everything I said before. You know, you can also see, do you have any clubs at your school, like a robotics club or a coding type club? And if you don't have it, you could start it. And that would be great on your college applications too, if you decide to go to college. So, you know, that's something you can do. If your school offers AP Computer Science, that's another route you can take. My school did not offer it, but you know, if your school has it, you could look into that. And also, if your school doesn't have AP Computer Science, you could go to your local community college, go in person, maybe take an online class, and take introduction to, you know, some coding language. Maybe it's Python, JavaScript, Swift, whatever the programming language is, you can take an introduction to that. At this stage, though, don't put too much pressure on yourself. Like, you know, you're really young, and I think as long as you get exposure to it and just kind of, you know, get a feel for it, that's all you really need at this stage.
Okay, y'all, now let's talk about different resources and programs that you can use to learn to code. So Google has a lot of different programs that you can take advantage of. So one of them is they have this program when you're transitioning from high school to college, you know, like that summer between. And what you can do is called the Computer Science Summer Institute. So definitely check that out. There's also other things as well, like you can have a Google engineer facilitate an hour of code for your school and also have a Google engineer like talk about what they do. So I think that's a cute little program, a cute fun program that they have. You know, you can check out Girls Who Code, amazing programs, Black Girls Code, amazing events and programs as well. Definitely check out Code with Klossy. They have like a lot of like summer programs that you can do. And then Girl Genius Mag. They have like so many different resources. Subscribe to their monthly newsletter. They post so many great resources. So definitely check them out. Yeah, when it comes to actually learning to code, so there's different resources for different coding languages. So I kind of have to know what coding language you want to learn, but I'll list some general resources that are great and you can see if the coding language you want to learn is there. So for example, Khan Academy, great, 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 great resource. There's Free Code Camp, Udemy, Coursera, so many different websites you can use. And if you know what language you want to learn, just comment below and maybe me or someone else will comment some resources that you can use. Finally, what I wanted to do, you made it this far in the video. If you made it this far in the video, comment below your favorite food, okay? Because I appreciate you. And people who comment your favorite food, I just want to let you know that I see you. So thank you so much for watching up until this point. If you like this video, definitely comment below, leave me a like, subscribe so you can see more videos like this. Finally, what I wanted to do was end with some advice. So y'all, learning to code was such a hard process for me. You know, there were some tears. It was really hard. You know, many times I felt like I couldn't do it. However, sticking with it, not giving up, was the best decision that I made probably in my entire life. So I'm glad I stuck with it. You know, learning anything can be tough. You know, let's say you're learning to skate. Some people might put on skates and be able to, you know, do a little something. Other people, it takes months to learn, and that's okay. You know, you kind of learn to enjoy the journey. And at the end of the day, whether it took you 1 month, 6 months, like y'all both gonna be skating side to side and you did the thing, you know what I'm saying? So that's something I wanna say. Keep at it. You know, you might meet some teachers you don't gel with. That's totally fine. Like, I just think that if you want to do this, there's a little part of you that's telling you like, you know, maybe I should learn to code. Definitely go for it. You can do it. Just keep at it. So yeah, thank you so much for watching this video and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.